Oh, really? Did they? Huh? Good idea. £8. Very good. Pheasants and Vegetables of Town. Brian R. Neil, Jeremy Carlisle. The people must have been drawn to a part of the painting with a painting brush and seeing it. You can just.
I mean, I was meaning to photograph it with.
Are they in an order, a chronological order?
They are mostly in groups, but there's an odd one due to my colleague arranging them. For instance, this was supposed to be Gala, but we've got three that are not Gala, but they've got horses in them, and they go together all right.
Mm-hmm.
Some of these events, of course, don't run anymore. No raft race, no bogey race.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I see Jimmy McGregor there. So many years does this span?
The whole
exhibition, how many years does it span? Do you know, offhand?
Well, I took photographs of the Morris dancers a long time ago and I didn't want to do it, but it worked out okay.
Uh-huh.
That's Oklahoma chorus lineup and Auchinleary beauty queen lineup.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a sports group here with cricket, golf, tennis, bowling, carpet bowling and curling.
Mm-hmm. So is that? Oh, that's Estranrar.
That's Estranrar.
Mm-hmm.
This is a big group of sports day at the Gatehouse.
Mm-hmm. So that's a hen on that girl's shoulder.
That's Fiona Gilligan. She was a cage bird
buff, uh-huh.
And she got the ladies' champion there.
Mm-hmm.
This is a Queen's guy. Your head is getting in the way.
Yeah.
And. Gatehouse scout troop above with the cobs. Competitors in the sport. And geysers. So when geysers used to be geysers.
Yeah.
Going out to entertain at Riverbank.
Mm-hmm.
This is the Lions Street Market. Which brought quite a few people to the town.
Yeah, it looks like.
There just might be a couple of thousand there. These are the trade pictures there.
Oh, there's Mum there. Yeah.
Yeah, with the fish for Fleric. This lady's now retired.
Mm-hmm.
That is not there anymore.
Yeah.
And the top one is not there anymore either.
Hmm.
This is the That's Life filming. Quite a few Kent faces in the audience there. Mm-hmm. They're all, most of them are holding up a wee belty.
Right.
This is Ernie Wise, who came to switch on the castle lights. Showing off his famous legs.
Yeah. Had the castle been lit before that?
And he's been driven down to the castle and joins in with Betty Forrest and her dancers in a wee routine. This group is under the heading of skills. The chap on the left is an MB for his services to sheep farming, a master at hand clipping. The collie dog handler looks as if he's in trouble, but in actual fact he does successfully pen those sheep.
I recognise Tony Wilkinson there. So Tony made his living from wood products.
He's a builder of the trade, but he turned his hand to anything. The man below is a builder as well, but I caught him doing this important job of putting this appreciative plaque to Mrs. Murray Usher. And below we've got the roof squad. There's only one of those guys alive now.
Yeah.
One that's standing there.
Right.
You get an arty job here.
Oh yeah.
Modelling clay West Highland cattle. Alex Wolfe. Above that, the lady, she taught Scottish dance for 53 years.
Is she one of the local McCullochs?
She's up from Ardwell.
Right.
And this is the last bale, the one the farmers all say they're looking for. It's a change of harvesting here. They used to grow oats and they used to have dairy cows, but they make bale silage now for beef cattle. Sam the barber, a local wee boy having a trim.
Where was he in the town? Where was his shop?
That was taken in Kakubri, but he was itinerant.
Right, okay.
Yes. Right. We've got a ploughman here at Ardwell. And Willie Mackay, our local blacksmith, shoeing a horse for the Stewartry show.
Very good.
These boys were winning a shield there. That's the ladies' football group, Matches Bouncers, appearing at the gala. Local football team, Fleet Star, with a new strip presented by Robin Raffle from the Murray Arms. We have the Dahlia master, Ian Gallagher, with four cups in this case.
And big sideburns.
And below we've got Gatehouse PR man George McCulloch, who was keen on filming with his friend Ned Fingland. Was He was manager of the Murray Arms at the time. Mm-hmm. We're sea rescue by the offshore boat here at Moss Yard. Harry Dawson, Willie McCulloch and Kerr McConkey, the team there. Above that, the stewartry, WRSA, were feeding abseilers who were performing on the viaduct.
For charity?
Hmm?
Were they doing it for charity?
I don't know. Mm-hmm. I was told that the abseilers were more interested in the cooking than the
abseiling.
But above that, you've got the local fire crew. I was tempted to use the Tump Trumpman names, but next is our Burns group. We have Nigel Hesketh as Holy Willie. Mm-hmm. Rehearsing his lines.
Yeah.
And above that, you've got Tam O'Shanter riding again with his faithful Meg.
That you constructed?
Oh, it's a life-size horse built for the gala by Mike Bannister.
Wonderful.
And it now is resting in the rafters of Ellisland Farm. This is James Finlay handing over the chair of office to Betty Keeble as she takes over the chair of the Gatehouse Burns Club. Robin Austin with a flourish dispatching a haggis. And an early Burns Club meeting of my experience, where James Finlay holds the floor with some amusing crack here. Above that is a distinguished top table group gathered for the protocol.
Very good.
This is a mixture here. The top two are really of worthies. Another Burns supper, printed a wee bit dark. Below we've got the three Jims. These Jimmy Logue, Jimmy Straighten, and Jim Campbell, our local respected worthies. Jim mm-hmm. Campbell was beadle at the Kirk.
Mm-hmm.
Below we've got the Gatehouse Bowling Club at their annual social, when socials used to be posh and folk dressed up.
Mm.
That one below is the old folks' Christmas party in the Murray Arms.
Yeah.
Now we've got some more skills. We've got Nigel Hesketh bottling his preserves. He always said it was a sticky business. Above that we have Jim Nicol at the boulder diking competition. A picture that makes your eyes water a wee bit.
Yeah, that looks a bit hefty.
And then we've got a couple of Galloway shots. We've got the black, traditional black Galloway being groomed at the sales in Castle Douglas by three local worthies. Below that we have the very pretty white Galloways, which are now registered as a rare breed.
Mm.
We've got three horsey pictures here. This is a very talented mare who climbed the battlements at Edinburgh Castle at the finale of the tattoo. At this time was being stabled in Lowberley. The one above is a reluctant pony I titled it Come On Steve. Above that we've got Watty McCulloch with his rare breed of Eriski ponies.
Yeah.
This is the school fete where our local Bobby is being pressed to buy a few plants. And then we've got George McCulloch in his post at Auctioneer in the Lions Whitsunday Street Market, charming money from the pockets of interested bidders. Next is the filming of the Legend of King Arthur by the BBC, and in the pictures here are local extras. This menacing guy is the local butcher waiting in the heather. Above that we've got the guys sharpening up their skills for the battle to come. And a group who are having a wee break between fights. Above that is the King Arthur is keeping court down at Lennox Plunton, which is close to Plunton Castle, where the jousting field was held. This group is the development of restoring of the mill and the fleet from a Delaric shell, ivy coloured, into what it is today, progressing it through a lot of work and skill. There's a footbridge which now bridges the river, was not there at that time. This is the big wheel at the neighbouring mill working. And the last picture is the opening day, which was Magnus Magnusson officiated.
Very good.
These are two celebration shots. This is the 200th centenary.
I should say the bicentenary of the local Masonic Lodge. And below that, the 50th anniversary of the opening of the new bowling green as it exists today.
A good clearance. Below that we've got the brave young motorcyclist at the tattoo in Edinburgh. You just wonder if this guy is going to get across. This picture is from my first experience of filming the Galloway Hills Rally. And this road was packed with snow and made it very tricky at the bridge at Lochinbreck. He did not complete the rally. We've got this is a wild sea job with the Port Patrick lifeboat did on its Sunday practice. They were just quite terrifying for somebody who was trying to photograph it. This is the Brig House windsurfing rally. The winner is not in that pack. He's way ahead. And above that is the first triathlon that was run in Kukubri. This guy is an expert swimmer, but looks as if he's going to lose his pants in the process. The bottom picture is our local postie, the late Jim Dugan. And above that is a talented artist, Archie Sutter Watt, RSW, tutoring at the summer school in Kukubri. The three pictures here are the three ministers that presided in Gatehouse prior to our current minister. Jack Henderson worked for the Kelly estate for 54 years, and here is receiving a certificate of appreciation from the Murray Usher family, fictured in Ann Street. Now, this is Jean Nelson, who won the Lions Club Star Prize and is having it handed to her by the president of the day, Harry Dorton. The celebration of Mrs. Murray Usher's 80th birthday was at Tersabon, and this group of local dignitaries. This is a picture where the McCulloch family from Ardwell are being congratulated of being Bank of Scotland's customers for 400 years. The guy presenting is bank manager John Riddick. The much respected and popular Dr. Kennedy McCreath received a presentation on his retirement from Jim Finlay, and a group of townspeople there to celebrate. This picture is the top table that sat at the reunion of the Kelly School, who were all pupils who evacuated from the west side of Glasgow. This is the day before they opened the bypass, just showing how busy it could get with all heavy wagons having to pass through the main street of Gatehouse. Now, Provost Alex Wolfe cut the first sod with a JCB, not with a wee shiny spade.
That's the way to do it.
This is the deepest cutting they were made on the 2 mile strip up from the river to the top of the hill. Below is the first vehicle to traverse the new road. It's the four-in-hand Clydesdale rig from Garliston, and riding shotgun was ex-chief inspector Peter Morton and local bobby Dennis Strange. The most respected person on the rig was the visiting chief postmaster from Dumfries, who came to make a personal same-day delivery to the post office in Gatehouse, where Piper Billy Cowie gave them a resounding welcome. This picture is very rare, never seen before. There isn't a soul or a car besides the gentleman in his C5 that evening. Never happened again.
Very strange. Thank you very much.